Over the last couple of months, a competition has been raging to find New Zealand's best red kids. The national champions were crowned on Sunday, who will now head to Canada to take on the world. To tell us more about his brainchild, the Kids Lit Quiz, please welcome to the cafe quizmaster Wayne Mills.
Yes, welcome, Wayne.
So Wayne, who took out the top prize?
Top prize taken out by Wellesley College. They defended their New Zealand title.
Oh, nice work. Yeah. And all boys in the team?
All boys, four boys. It's, you know, when people say boys don't read, they want to come along and see this quiz.
These boys do.
And how long's this quiz been going for?
26 years.
26 years.
Look, I could not believe that after 26 years I'm still doing it, and it's going from strength to strength.
So how did you come up with the idea?
Well, if you think back to 1991, New Zealand was still in euphoria from the Rugby World Cup, and sport and netball were very important to New Zealand, and there was nothing like this for kids. If kids really enjoyed reading, what recognition did they get? None. You got recognition for maths or science, but really nothing if you love reading. So I thought, well, let's start a sort of literary competition. That's what I imagined. Had 14 teams. Now, 26 years later, five continents and thousands of kids all around the world.
And it's a good sign too, isn't it, that they are reading still, because a lot of people would assume that in this modern era of screens, there's not a lot of reading going on.
The actual research is showing that the strong area is in children's literature and YA. That hasn't really diminished. It's a strong area with reading, and kids are quite comfortable reading both.
Yeah.
Read the screens Kindle too, Mike, by the way, because there is
still.
But what it is because parents like me take their devices off them at a certain time of day and force them to read, and they love it. Once they get into it, the book, they love it.
Yep.
So the winners of this team going to Canada to compete?
They go to Toronto, and it's a very, very special year for Canada because it's their sesquicentennial, 150 years they're celebrating. It'll be a big party. Canadians know how to party. It'll be a big, huge party. These kids will go to Niagara Falls. They'll be given red carpet treatment.
Wow.
They'll go up the tallest building in Canada. They are going to do amazing things.
And what's the average age of the kids in the team?
The Wellesley team kids would all be, average age would be about 12 and a half, but they can be between 10 and under 14 on the 1st
That's
of
great.
July.
Okay, and in terms of how we stack up against the rest of the world, how does New Zealand go?
New Zealand's always done well. We have literature programs pretty popular in New Zealand, and that's where we've seen the shift in emphasis from reading for comprehension when the three of us are at school to now reading for pleasure.
Right.
It's reading for pleasure that you want to cultivate.
It is what you want to cultivate, because once they love that reading, everything becomes much better, and they think clearer because they're reading these interesting ideas.
Oh, yeah.
And who pays for all of this?
Well, there are entry fees that go towards it, and then the winning team receives $6,000 to help them in their travel costs. But once they're in Canada, everything's paid for.
Oh, brilliant.
Wow. Everything.
And okay, nice.
Do you have to write all the questions
for
this?
And believe me, that is incredibly difficult, because the questions have to be generically and internationally fair for kids from, say, Johannesburg, kids from Edinburgh, kids from, Singapore.
How do you do that?
Well, there are some, globalisation's helped a lot, because there's not a kid in the world that doesn't know the Wimpy Kid or Lord of the Rings, or mythology will translate, Hunger Games. So, I've got to look, I have to know what is on the bookshelves in every country.
You've got to read a lot of kids' books, don't you? What's your favourite right now?
Favourite right now? I've just read Ingo by Helen Dunmore, and that's about mer people off the coast of Cornwall.
That sounds good.
Yeah, well.
Okay. Right, should you test us?
Okay,
so we have to pick a buzzer.
I'm really worried about this.
What's your buzzer noise?
I'm going to be a cat.
Okay, I'll be a dog then.
Okay.
So you ask the question, and if we know it, we buzz in.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, I'm terrible at fast paced things, but go. Let's give it a whirl. Sure.
Okay, this would be a question that I'd ask, say, for orphans. The series of unfortunate events by Lemony Snicket, the Baudelaire children are orphans. Do you know why their parents perished? What happened to their parents?
Oh.
Oh, no, I just did the buzzer, but I haven't any idea. They were in a fire?
Yeah, absolutely. In a fire? Yeah. You want another?
Yeah, okay, go.
Okay, this would be, put this one on space or galaxies.
Oh,
what planet was Superman from?
Woof, woof!
Krypton.
Yes.
I would have got that one.
No, okay. Didn't bark fast
enough. I know, give me one more.
Category on animal cruelty.
Okay, go.
What famous horse book inspired Victorians to treat their horses better?
Ruff, ruff. Go. I have no idea. I just wanted to bark like
Black
a dog.
Stallion?
It's Black.
Black Beauty. Black Beauty. Did you get them inside that too? Yeah. I should let you have one, shouldn't I?
Oh, my goodness.
Ruby.
Okay.
Ruby winning like that?
Well, I clearly need to read a lot more, I think,
you
after that.
You have to bark
that.
Faster.
Yeah, nice. Hey, well, congratulations on everything that's happened.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining us. That was fun. That was fun. We wish Wellesley College in Lower Hutt all the best at the world final. It'd be so much better than us.
Yes.
And if you want more details about the Kids Lit quiz, just head along to the website.